Today is day
4.
I don't know what day it's gonna be, but it's that day of Dark Hair, Don't Care Week. Today's video is going to be complete FAQ, Q&A, all about my hair. I get tons of questions all the time and I can't answer them all. So I asked you guys on my community page to ask me questions about my hair. So I'm gonna answer like what I use, what my routine is. I'm even gonna show you how I cut my hair. Yes, I do cut my hair myself. So if you guys are interested in hearing about that, then keep watching. So I'm going to go on the community page right now and read some of your questions. I guess I'll start off first by telling you what kind of hair I have, because that's what seems to be like a big question. From what I had heard from my hairdresser friend and other hairdressers is that I have fine to normal hair, but a lot of it. I always thought I had really thick hair, but like the shafts of my hair are not thick. It's just I have a lot of hair. Lot of it. I used to hate it in high school. I literally, you know those like shearing, what are those called, thinning scissors or whatever? I bought a pair of them from like Kmart and I was trying my hardest to make my hair look like Avril Lavigne's hair, which if you remember her hair like back in the day, it was very thin, very flat, and I just thought that looked amazing and my hair did not do that. I would stop at nothing to get it and I chopped my hair off like crazy. Right now, this is day 2 of a curl. My hair does not hold curl very well. It just likes to do what it's doing, staying straight. I have naturally straight hair. I can curl it and hairspray it, but it always just ends up like this. Like wavy. I can never get like really, really curly hair. That is kind of hair that I have. Hair that likes to do what it wants to do and only that. Kaylee asked, how do you keep your hair so silky? I assume you use straighteners and hair dryers for your hair. Mine gets dried and frayed. So like I said, my hair likes to do what it wants to do. It is very hard to change. Like I said, the curls, it doesn't like change at all. It also means that it is very resistant to damage. I've done some stuff to it, like you guys see. Like I don't actually use like a lot of bleach, but even when I did use bleach once on like a strip of hair and I left it in for a long time, it was still really, really silky and healthy. And usually when you do that to your hair, especially at home, it doesn't stay as nice. But yeah, this question a lot about my hair, how I keep it so silky. And it is like literally like the genetics of my hair, why it looks like silky. Right now is not as silky because I kind of waved it. It's kind of knotted up from hairspray, but I actually do not really use anything special on my hair right now. I'm looking to use some more stuff for split ends, and I know there was another question in there about split ends, so I like to trim it every once in a while, which I'll show you later how I do that. But that's probably my biggest hair concern is split ends, but the rest of my hair has always been really smooth and really nice to the touch. Everyone's always like, you have the most beautiful hair. It sounds so conceited, but it just never really put that much work into it, and I guess that kind of followed me to adulthood. I never started a routine as I was younger, so now that I have even less time, less free time, I don't really do too much. This is the shampoo that I use. This is the Signature Care Dandruff Shampoo because the Head & Shoulders was a little expensive this past shopping trip, so we ended up going with the No Name. Bruce uses this as well, so that's why it's like covered and like just not the prettiest bottle, like all wet. This stuff actually smells really good though. This is the shampoo that I use, and I don't use a conditioner because it makes my hair look oily the next day. Just the dandruff shampoo. Oh yeah, Hessa K asked what shampoo and conditioner I use, so there you go. Megan asked, what everyone wants to know, what is your ride or die thing to do to grow out your hair? Like, I don't really know what I do differently from anyone else, why my hair grows. It is always grown really, really fast, but I do not wash my hair very often. I wash my hair, and that was another question. I wash my hair probably every 3 days. The day of, it's usually just wet for the entire day, because like I said, I have a lot of hair, so it takes forever for it to dry. It's so annoying. I literally can't do anything unless I want to blow dry it for an hour. So I don't really have to worry about washing it. And especially if I don't do any physical activity, like if I don't work out. A lot of us do have jobs where we're just sitting down for a long time. The next day, which would be the third day, is usually the day that I use a dry shampoo. I wash it the next day. Depending, obviously, on if anything crazy happens. You know, in Arizona, I had to shower a little bit more. I really don't wash that often. I feel like I have tons of like natural oils going on like that. Third day is when it starts to look kind of crazy, and if I'm not going anywhere, I don't use a dry shampoo. I just let it do its thing. I guess maybe it's that. I read online somewhere that if you don't wash your hair for too long though, then the oils build up or something can actually hurt your hair growing. It'll like plug stuff up. I don't know, I have no idea. Chirosima? So you have a ton of hair, because I do, it's heavy. Gives me headaches, but still manages to look flat and boring. How can you make it look with volume and flirt? The volume part is definitely what I have the most trouble with, but let me grab the thing that's absolutely amazing. Ick Sexy Hair Volume Gel. Literally amazing. It works wonders. The only thing is that you will definitely not be able to have a second day hair. Whenever I use like any type of product like that, the first day is great. Like you get the volume, all that stuff, but the next day it does look greasy. Basically, after you get the shower and your hair is still wet, pump a little bit of the product, put it around your roots and then just blow dry it till like dry. You get like a ton of volume, tons of volume. It will feel a little like hairspray in your hair, but it's so nice. Also, my other trick for volume is to absolutely curl my hair, whatever you call this, curl, wave. I spray hairspray upside down, flip over, tons of volume, like tons of volume. Also, I wanted to let you guys know what my biggest hair problem is and how I kind of fixed it or whatever. So when I first started living in California, I don't know why. In Pennsylvania, I never had this issue, but the minute I moved to California, my hair started to get the worst knots, like huge knots, right at like the nape of my neck. It's just so funny because I never had that issue when I was living in Pennsylvania, but California, Arizona, I just always had that. Wearing a scarf in the winter time is the worst. You have your scarf wrapped around and the hair right here like rubs against the scarf and it just becomes this big ball of knot. I have an Instagram video actually showing me removing the knot and everything that I do for it. So my hair, I've read it could be from like split ends. My hair isn't necessarily dry, but it's probably a tiny bit dry. But what I really, really found helped was conditioner, and I know I don't use it, so that's probably why. I sometimes use it on the bottom half, but never like the top half. Flossie's 3-Minute Miracle Moist Deep Conditioner. There's a good bunch of these. It is amazing. I don't have it right now, but it was my saving grace, and then I just started to deal with it. But it would really keep my hair from getting knotted up or anything, and it made it feel so healthy and moisturized. So get it on your hands, and your hands will feel immediately smoother. So you leave it on your hair for like 3 minutes. It's just like butter. I really need to get that again. I just stopped buying it because I've just been so busy with everything else, but that was hands down the best thing for my biggest problem. So Destiny asked, what's the best type of dry shampoo? So I do have another video testing out 2 of the dry shampoos for darker hair, so definitely check that out. I've been kind of going between this Sexy Hair H2 No. So this stuff, it does leave my hair a little bit, not chalky, but it's not the greatest. So this stuff I did not find left my hair with like a white cast. I wouldn't necessarily say that I recommend it, like get out, go out and get this or anything, but it's just been what I've been using and it's been working. I feel like there's better out there, that's why I want to keep trying more, but I haven't run into problems with this particular one. But I'll definitely keep you posted in future videos and other videos. I really want to try a lot more dry shampoos and see what is the best. I'm gonna move on to showing you guys how I cut my hair because this video will be really, really long. But one more thing, because I get this question a lot. This is my natural hair color. Completely natural, have not colored this color. So I've been told time and time again the importance of having nice quality hair shears. And with that important information, I bought the cheapest ones I could find from, I don't know, 7 years ago. They're Goody, I know. We're just gonna let it go and use these. And I will say, this is going to be my worst angle. I filmed this once before for a vlog, I think. It is the worst possible angle anyone can have. Pick the cutest celebrity that you know of. It's the worst angle. So all I'm gonna use is a hair tie and scissors. I'm actually gonna change my shirt real quick. We're gonna see if I can cut most of this blue off because it was a little bit haphazard. I don't know if we're gonna get off, but the most of it is what we're aiming for. So what I'm going to do, this isn't any technique I created. There's a bunch of videos. I got this off of YouTube and an eHow article, I think. I'm gonna turn my head over here. You see that? I love this angle. Oh, I'm gonna need a brush too. And I'm just gonna take my hairbrush and I'm just gonna brush all the way down, making sure there's no knots or tangles. Just let it hang, let gravity hang. You don't want anything to be bunched up anywhere weird. And this is to give you layers, because I like layers. I don't want like a straight cut or whatever. I'm gonna pull it into a ponytail like right here. And I am doing this with dry hair. Gotta brush it, make sure. Then I'm gonna tie it off with a hair tie. And if your hair is anything like my length, your back should be hurting right now. It's so painful to hold your head like that. You can see my hair is pretty much that length. So you can see I've done this before. There's obviously a little bit of whatever, but it's pretty much like that. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take these scissors and I'm literally just gonna cut straight across. I put a lot of blue in there, didn't I? It's all the way up here. Boom. Oh, I got a little bit heavy on that one right there. It's okay, we're going for a layered anyway. Actually, I think I'm gonna do even more. I really want my hair to not be this long. I don't want it short, but I don't want it to be this long. I'm just gonna cut it like this. This entire video is gonna be so cringe-worthy to hairdressers, I feel like, if my entire channel isn't already. And just to see if I wanna take off more, I'll take this pony out, toss it back. It's still really long. See how this piece is like shorter than that piece, that kind of thing? Thing, that's where the layers are coming in. We need to chop more.
All right, so I have about what I want to start with. You can see the length. It feels already a million times lighter. Just put my hair straight like this. Tie it again. Nape of my neck. I just wanna make the very last layer just a little shorter. Just kind of customizing it now. So now what we're gonna do is fine tune the front parts especially. I need to actually part my hair the right way, part it in the middle, and then I'm just gonna take, there's like a section of hair that seems to be the most chunky, if you will. So I always do this, see how there's like kind of an angle going there? I just over accentuate that angle more using the scissors, shears, brush it out. I'm gonna use my fingers to hold them sort of how they are laying. And then I just go up and down with the scissors to cut it more into an angle. And then I do the same on this side. I'm not done with this, but just wanna show you guys, I do the same exact thing. In the middle here, I'll choose how short I want the very first piece of hair. And then I just kind of angle it down from where I wanna start. Just snip all the way down so I get that nice little scientific and everything. Then I'll turn around. This is what the hair looks like right now. I'll take a picture, see if there's any crazy spots that I'm missing. It should kind of go in a V. Here are the results of my haircut. So as you can see, there are layers going through everything, and it kind of is in a V towards the bottom and the middle. Love it. Good length, actually. I don't mind this length. I don't know if you can tell as well because there are curls in it, but this part is shorter than this part, than this part. So when we cut that in an angle, that's how we get that nice kind of line right there too. I just thought it'd be kind of fun to show you guys my process. By no means was that meant to be a tutorial. Definitely look up the videos. If I can find them, I'll leave a link to the one that I used. I used like 4 different ones and kind of put together my own method, but that's just how I do it. I hope I answered a good amount of questions for you guys. If you have any others, you can leave them down below and I'll answer them in the comments. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in my next video. Bye!